So in this video, we will be discussing the 1D collision. So this is the theory. Let me show you the simulation I am having over here. So I'll have to sign up. Wait a minute. After signing up, this is the simulation provided here. So if you have not performed this experiment in the lab, you can perform this in online simulation. So this is the two cars shown here, and this is the graph between momentum and time, velocity and time, kinetic energy and time. I'll show you example and then we will just discuss this as a whole. First of all, for elastic collision, we can choose it like, let for inelastic collision, I'll choose the coefficient of restitution and then somewhat values, and experiment will start here. So this is how this collision is shown, graphs are made, and also you will get the result like this. So we'll start from the very basic. This is what I just need to show you. So let us discuss the theory first. I'll provide the link of this in description box. Elastic and inelastic collision aim. Basically, this is given. Our aim is to calculate the momentum, kinetic energy, and velocity after collision. So in this theory, what is collision? Simple questions asked in Viva are like that only. What is collision? What is the principle of experiment? What is the difference in elastic and inelastic collision? Simple kind of questions are asked. So from here you can read the theory that what is a collision. You can just describe it in a single line or what your teachers require actually according to that. Basic principle here is the conservation of flows which are applied. Momentum is always conserved in every kind of collision. It can be elastic, it can be inelastic collision, but momentum is always conserved. Kinetic energy is conserved only in elastic collision and not in inelastic collision. So the question asked frequently in Viva is that where does that energy goes? Does it violate the law of conservation of energy? So the answer is no. The energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It only converts from one form to another. So in case of inelastic collision, the kinetic energy is converted to some other form. It can be heat energy, it can be vibration. In some cases, it can be like light energy and sound energy also. So it is just converted. Energy is not lost, but yes, there is loss in kinetic energy in inelastic collision. But it does not violate the law. So this is simple things you must know. Types of collision, we know elastic collision and inelastic collision. I have already told that these things happen, and you must just know one or two examples also, like collision between two steel or glass bowl is nearly elastic. Inelastic, most of the collisions in our daily life are inelastic. Formulas used in this experiment, we know we have to conserve the momentum. Kinetic energy, this is for your elastic collision. We can find the velocities after collision like this. Special case, if m1 is equals to m2, then this will be equals, and this is also a special case. You can read it from here. You can remember these also for some written kind of questions which are asked in exams. Conservation of momentum, this is our coefficient of restitution. So this is basically what question is asked in Viva, that do you know the coefficient of restitution? What is it? So yes, this is the ratio of velocities after separation along line of impact divided by velocities after collision. Like this we can see. So this is the ratio of after collision upon before collision. I think I had told wrong earlier. So finally you can see it from here. And in a perfectly elastic collision, coefficient of restitution is 1. for perfectly inelastic collision it is zero. And what do you mean by these perfectly inelastic and elastic collision? You must know. Just go through it for once. Simple questions are asked in Viva, and a very important and somewhat different question asked is of super elastic collision. Have you ever heard of super elastic collision? What is it? Any example? Does it violate the law? So yes, in super elastic collision, coefficient of restitution is greater than 1, and the kinetic energy increases after the collision. So it is a special kind you can study if it is asked in your exam. So here is it, the procedure. Procedure is simply given for the simulation I'll perform. I'll just tell you. Self-evaluation mein some questions are given. Which of the following statement is true in case of inelastic collision? So this is obviously like only linear momentum is conserved. In case of inelastic collision, kinetic energy is not conserved. Both cannot be conserved. So A option will be the answer. We will check the answers finally. Coefficient of restitution for a perfectly elastic body. This is actually we know is equal to 1. Unit of impulse. Impulse is what force into time. So both will be correct. So both A and B, I think so. We will check the answers. When two bodies stick together after collision, the collision is said to be perfectly inelastic. The collision between gas molecules of ideal gas in a cylinder is what will be the answer? Perfectly elastic. This is an important question. Now let us submit. So yes, these are the answers and these are correct. Fine, so we will move towards the next step, that is simulation. You can also do the assignment. I'll show you the questions. You can practice. You can pause the video, write down the questions and practice, or I'll provide you the link in the description box. Okay, so let us start with simulation. This is what kind of I had shown you at the starting of the video. So here two cards, two car or anything can be there which collide, and you have to plot the graph between momentum and time, velocity and time, kinetic energy and time. So let us start. Here you have to click, and if you are not able to understand what to do, you can click here. This will tell you the first step, that select the type of text. Next, it will tell you all the steps. Okay, you can see it from here, and also the steps are given here also in self-evaluation. So okay, we will start. So here the variables are given. So you can take the reading for let it be elastic. First of all, coefficient of restitution will be 1. Object, let us take A. Velocity, we can select any. Negative will just signify the direction. So let us have the positive. Mass, you can take any. And basically what the profit of doing it here is that you will get the reading simply. So these are the graphs. I'll provide you the link if you have any problem in understanding from here. You can do it by yourself also. Click it here and results are shown. Before collision, kinetic energy according to the velocity what we had selected, okay, and velocity, momentum, kinetic energy, and after collision, it's like that. What actual, you know, the observation is, first of all we know that this was elastic collision, so kinetic energy must remain same. So add the kinetic energy of object A and B, this will give 73.5. Now after collision, add the both velocities, अगेन इट विल गिव यू 73.5, एडिंग 18.4 प्लस 55.1, अगेन दिस विल बी 73.5. इट मीन्स दैट काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज कंजर्व्ड. नेक्स्ट, मोमेंटम इज कंजर्व्ड इन एवरी केस, सो आफ्टर एडिंग दिस 10.5 प्लस 10.5 यू विल गेट 21. हेयर ऑल्सो मोमेंटम इज 21. ऑल्सो रिमेंबर ऑफ कीप इन माइंड द यूनिट्स. That is also asked in Viva. So now let us change it. First of all, stop this. ये graph move कर रहे हैं. Pause, reset. Again, we will do. Let us do now for inelastic collision. Inelastic collision. It's not easy to use actually. Now you can set the coefficient of restitution whatever you wish, like this. Okay, I wish to set it like, let it be 0.5. Object this time I am taking A, velocity I am taking minus 78, mass I am taking 2 kg, and I am starting the experiment. So yes, you can see that it has moved here and collided. These are the graphs. Again, you can have the observations here. This is your observation table before collision and after collision. Now see that momentum is again conserved. Again, momentum is minus 80 only in this case and this case. But because it was inelastic collision, kinetic energy is not conserved. You can add this and add this. Kinetic energy, there are losses in the energy. So where that loss goes into, it changes into some other form. Okay, you can pause it, reset, and put the values whatever you want. Graphs will be made for you here only, right? And easily you can perform. You can select any of the object, velocities, mass, whatever you want to. So this is how you can perform the simulation and get the readings. Assignment I have shown you. So we can, you know, practice questions from here. So hope you people like this video. Thanks for watching.